Listening Library presents Katie Kazoo, Switcheroo, Number 21, I'm Game, by Nancy Krulik. Read for you by Cassandra Morris.
Chapter 1. Hurry up, Daddy, it's starting, Katie Kazoo shouted. She turned on the television set in the living room just as the familiar theme music began to play. Welcome to Tick Tock Clock, the game show that pits speed against smarts, the show's star, Bob Ritchie, said. Did I miss anything? Mr. Kazoo asked as he leaped onto the couch beside Katie. Just the song, Katie assured him. She knew her dad hated missing even a minute of his favorite TV game show. Katie liked Tick Tock Clock a lot, too. The questions they asked were usually too hard for her, but she liked watching what happened when the contestants answered incorrectly. They had to do all kinds of weird things in order to stay in the game, like fill a bucket with milk, using only their cupped hands to carry the milk across the stage. Or search around with their mouths in a big bowl of goo to find a jelly bean. Or catch water balloons on a spoon while they rode on a unicycle. Or slither through a maze on their bellies like a snake. The hardest part was that the contestants had to finish their stunt before the tick-tock clock buzzed. If they didn't, they were out of the game. Name the capital of New York State, Bob Ritchie asked the contestants. Albany, Katie's father replied right away. He smiled confidently. That was an easy one. Katie smiled proudly at her dad. You'd win if you were on the show, she said. Mr. Kazoo grinned. Probably. When it comes to answering questions, I'm the champ. Here at home you are, Katie's mom teased as she sat down on the couch. But I'll bet it's not that easy when you're playing against two other people and you have those TV cameras staring at you. Mr. Kazoo shrugged and listened to Bob Ritchie's next question. Whose picture is on the $100 bill? Bob asked the contestants. Benjamin Franklin, Katie's father shouted out. The contestant on TV said, President Kennedy. Sorry, that's incorrect, Bob Ritchie told the woman on TV. The correct answer is Benjamin Franklin. Mr. Kazoo nodded. Told ya, he said. Katie and her parents watched as the contestant spun a big wheel. There were six pictures on the wheel. A snake, a bowl of green goo, a chicken, a unicycle, and a cow with a milk pail. I wonder what stunt she'll get, Katie said. The wheel went round and round and finally stopped on the picture of a chicken. Bob Ritchie grinned. You know what that means, he said to the audience as he handed the woman a pair of roller skates, a raincoat, and a rain hat. The rain hat had a glass bowl attached to it. Katie giggled as the woman put on the hat. Boy, she looks funny. Bob Ritchie pointed up. There were three large cardboard chickens swaying overhead from the ceiling. Those are the tick-tock clock chickens, Bob explained to the woman. As soon as I say go, they will start laying eggs. You have 1 minute to skate around and catch five eggs in the bowl on the top of your head. He paused and smiled at the camera. On your mark, get set. Go. Suddenly, an egg fell from one chicken and then another. It was hard to tell which chicken would lay the next egg. The woman started skating, trying to catch them in her hat. She wasn't very good at it. She kept missing. Raw eggs splattered on the floor. Egg slime sloshed all over her. No wonder they gave her a raincoat, Mrs. Kazoo noted. This is a really hard stunt, Mr. Kazoo said. Katie turned and smiled at her dad. It would be so great if you could be on the show. I'm sure you would win lots of prizes. I know, Mr. Kazoo replied sadly. but Tick-Tock Clock is filmed in Hollywood. There's no way I can ever be on it. Katie frowned. That just didn't seem fair. Chapter 2. Woohoo! Mr. Carew shouted the next morning. He was reading the newspaper at the breakfast table. I don't believe it! What? Katie and her mom asked him at the same time. Tick-Tock Clock, Mr. Carew replied. The show is going on a tour. They will be filming in different cities all over the country. And on Friday, they're going to be here. In Cherrydale? Katie's mother exclaimed. This Friday? Daddy, you have to get on the show, Katie cried out. This article gives you a phone number to call to try out, Mr. Carew told her. How can you try out over the telephone? Katie asked her dad. It says here that there will be 4 questions you have to answer, Mr. Carew read. If you answer 4 correctly, then you may be picked to be on Tick-Tock Clock. Call right away, Katie shouted. I'll bet half of the people in Cherrydale are calling that phone number right now. Mr. Carew leaped up and ran to the phone. Katie, please go get your backpack, Mrs. Carew said. I'll drive you to school on my way to work. But I want to see if Daddy can answer those 4 questions, Katie pleaded. Sorry, her mom said. We've got to get going or I'll be late. Katie frowned, but she hurried upstairs. Her chocolate and white cocker spaniel, Pepper, nipped at her heels as she ran. Wouldn't it be so exciting if Daddy got to be on TV? Katie asked Pepper as she slipped her math worksheet into her homework folder. Pepper smiled and wagged his tail excitedly. Katie grinned. Sometimes she was sure that her dog understood everything she said. See you later, Katie told Pepper. Then she raced back to the kitchen. Mom, I'm ready, she said. Her mother was standing at the kitchen door. Shh, she whispered. Mrs. Carew pointed to the phone. Daddy's answering those questions for the test. Katie could hardly believe it. Madagascar, Katie's father said into the phone. Katie crossed her fingers and her toes. She hoped it was the right answer. Yes, Mr. Carew shouted suddenly. Katie grinned. That's the 3rd one he got right, Mrs. Carew whispered to Katie. 1 more to go. Katie's heart beat hard as her father listened to the last question. How do cows sleep? He repeated. Standing up? Katie bit her lip nervously. Was that the right answer? Suddenly, a huge smile spread across Katie's father's face. Wow! He shouted excitedly. That's great! Okay, Friday evening at 6:30. I'll be there. After he hung up the phone, Katie's dad hugged her mom. I don't believe it! I made it! He shouted. This is incredible! I'm going to be on Tick-Tock Clock. I guess wishes do come true, Mrs. Carew said with a smile. Katie gulped. Her mother was right. Wishes did come true. Unfortunately, it wasn't always so great when they did. Chapter 3. Katie knew all about wishes, especially the kind that came true. One of her wishes had come true. And it kept on coming true over and over again. It had all started one horrible day back in 3rd grade. Katie had lost the ball game for her team. Then she'd splashed mud all over her favorite jeans. But the worst part of the day came when Katie let out a loud burp, right in front of the whole class. It had been so embarrassing. That night, Katie made a wish that she could be anyone but herself. There must have been a shooting star overhead when she made the wish. Because the very next day, the magic wind came. The magic wind was a really powerful tornado that blew only around Katie. It was so strong, it could blow her right out of her body.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.